Okie dokie, so looks like we're gonna start off in Smashville. Oh, it doesn't get the fastball on the downer there. I think it's maybe trying to catch, yeah, I guess carrying for the blast on the bat. Rack up the on curve. Oh. Yeah, that's the thing usually. So one of the things that Anthony can do is like when he's holding a grenade actually, like so like, it doesn't matter if you hit him, like if he's holding a grenade, like a lot of like, what will happen more often than not is the grenade will momentum cancel. I'm not sure if going up there like, is the answer. I think Dan does need to cover some space, but he's got to be a little careful. Maybe just kind of hang on the platform. Strong hit from either of these guys can end the game. Oh. Oh, down smash? No, good DI. Wow. I'm probably just not gonna do that. I'm just gonna leave it as is. All right, yeah. So, for those unaware, port priority is a thing, so you can expect over these next couple games for the ports to switch back and forth. This one's not too bad. Again, yeah, the low ceiling will probably help make finish things off the top. Although, Smear is going to have to be aware that the this does help Kirby's up air. Again, the momentum cancel on the grenade. Oh, and looks like this spot goes a little too deep there. Alright, there we go. Back arrow CO. Still pretty close. Although 2665 does have a lot of damage on him, so it won't take much for Smear to kill him. You have to be pretty careful as approaches. Too bad. So, game 1 was Smashville, game 2 was PSAT. Alright, so here we are going to Thumb. Yeah, these tripods are where I think Snake really thrives, because the thing is, if there's a mine or grenade hanging out on one of those platforms, like, you can't really be anywhere near those areas. Oh, like a sleeping bag right to the last zone. That was the DI.
Oh.
I think, yeah, I was probably going for the up air there, but yeah, I wasn't able to connect it. Cool. Alright. Back to his own mind. If you ever get clipped by the second hand of the cypher, then usually the upper is guaranteed. Again, Dan just seems to be reaching. I'm not sure. Like, if Snake's on that top hat, again, you just kind of have to get him out and like just let him come to you. Is racking up the damage here. If he's able to get a solid hit on Snake and take a stock, then this is still very doable for him. Alright, there we go. Alright. Manages to find it. Again, but he's in a tough spot because like, the thing is, Spear doesn't really have to approach. He can just get the sustain advantage, and I think he can just kind of chill at him, but let Spear come to him. Oh, there it is. All right, takes the game. There you go. Good stuff. Correct. Correct, yes, for you, yep. Alright, Metal Cavern. Peace out of that. Proposition. Oh, if he it closes the gap. Oh. Oh, I see. I managed to get the upper on there. I like how Dan's trying to keep, take account of the cipher with his backers. Like, he's trying to space it so that it'll connect even if he gets the wrong bird box on his back air. Gets hit with a point blank crank. Oh, and yeah, he gets hit with a spike hitbox. That was a good stringy hat going, but yeah, it wasn't really looking clean. Like, has port priority, and there's no platforms here. So one of the tools that Samurai really relies on is just like dropping a grenade and then shielding. Like the thing is, he's not going to be getting he's not going to be advantaged in that situation more often than not, because if they both just kind of sit there again, like 2665 is not going to take knockback, Samurai will. So. Again, looks like 265 has gotten some good percent on Smear. Oh, into the mine. Oh, doesn't get left there. Looking really good for 2665. Having a stock up on snake is definitely you want to keep, like, keep out of it. Oh. I've read the prank. Oh, and it has him off stage. Oh, damn. Kind of like anticipating fear drop, but didn't. I was actually reading the hammer. Oh, man. Momentum canceled by the grenade again.